It's your time to shine.
What's up, guys? It's your girl, Bro G. Happy birthday! Yes, it's the birthday episode. Right now, we're live at DTF Radio on Wednesdays from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. Eastern Time. Yes, guys, with my co-host, Bro G, and co-host, The Loud Mouth. Yes. So, guys, I'm excited. As you guys see, we got a little decoration. We did what we could. Yes, today officially is my birthday, and we have a great show for you guys today. We have a great lineup of artists coming through. We have a few in the building. We have amazing artists, a few of them are. We got artists Amaj, Real Lyrics. We got La Señora Bolero. We also got Chronic. And we're going to have GeoNova.com. So stay tuned for that. Today's amazing show. Great lineup of artists performing. And artists have their songs playing, and we have a great show. So stay tuned, stay tuned. Also, guys, you can follow me on my Instagram at OfficialBeroG. All that said and done. Also, you can find Captain Clutch, or as his Instagram, or The Loud Mouth, as we all know him, at Captain Clutch 80 as his Instagram. You can follow him there as well. Okay, quick announcements on here, guys. Check out the September issue of the Vero G Spotlight magazine. It's out now, of course, at www.madcloud.com. Go support that, guys, if you get a chance to. I appreciate that. We have three issues on there. Cynthia Ortega, John DePedro, and we got Terry B on those issues. So definitely go support that. Also, guys, besides that, October issue will be out this Saturday, October 1st. So stay tuned for that very briefly when, it's in and everything else. With that said and done. So, guys, again, we have a lot of things here. Also, we're making the 30th anniversary of the Vero G Spotlight magazine, which has been the third year for October 1st, coming up this Saturday. Woo-hoo! I'm excited. Also, guys, we'll be making this week as well the four-year anniversary of the Vero G Spotlight TV show. So, a big applause for that. I wish I had a soundboard here. But, yes, again, it's the four-year anniversary of the amazing TV platform we first did before we did any of the branches or platforms for all these amazing artists out there, and more to come. Stay tuned for that. Yes, also, guys, last week we apologize for those who were tuning in who did call. Thank you. Who I think it was Mr. Abel called, I think it was it. So, thank you for acknowledging and noticing that our time he was talking here, it was kind of muted. But don't worry, guys, like I said again, we're here, we're fully now equipped and aware that we won't be muted for this show today, so we're good. also, like I said, we got a lot of great things coming up soon, guys. I will keep you all posted in due time, further more on that. All right, so we got right into artist spotlight segment. So, yes. We are right now going right into artist spotlight segment. Are you guys excited?
Yeah.
I like the sound of that. Thank you guys, appreciate that. Alright guys, so let's get right into it. Our first guest in the building. Let's give it up for La Señora Bolero.
I'm good. I'm so glad over here, Veronica. Finally meet you in person.
Yeah, definitely. I was just saying how Facebook, social media, and how people we know are mutual friends. It's just amazing to meet people like yourself and people like in general in the room as well. So
I have a lot of admiration for you. I'm your fan. And I want you to know that. That's from the bottom of my heart. I see you every day and do a big circle to follow. God bless you and keep you there and up there.
Thank you. I'm your president. Thank you, mommy. Oh, headphones.
Yeah, put the headphones on.
Yeah, because you have to hear yourself. Yeah.
The headphones.
Yeah. Okay, I'm alert to hear, so yeah.
Okay.
Oh, he got excited. Uh oh. Listen, I didn't do it. I don't know shit. I'm not paying for that.
It wasn't me.
No, it didn't distract me. Yeah. Oh my god!
What the fuck?
Oh lord! I agree. Alright, back to the show, guys. So,
loose.
Before we continue on, I'm honored to have, like I said, we talked to each other a couple times. And it's just nice. Like,
well, I can't play the music now.
Who are always encouraging to me and also saying no. Are things that we need to just support each other in your life. So, yeah, I thank you for that.
You're welcome. My pleasure. It's been my pleasure meeting you and. Aww. Since you're in my life, it's been better.
That's a good thing.
Yes.
No problem. So let's get right into it. So you have before we get to the album, let's get into who you are. Tell the viewers right now, watching listeners, who is La Señora Bolero?
La Señora Bolero is a Puerto Rican lady. Mm-hmm. that loves everybody, of course. And I grew up in Puerto Rico, and I grew up with the music bolero. So all my life, I've been a bolerista, but since I was four. I remember the first song that I liked, and it was my grandmother singing it. And that song has been so important in my life, and I recorded, and it's out there too. And I'm the first person in the whole world that records this song as a bolero.
Oh my God.
Yes.
You're kidding. So that's been for a long time then you've been doing it.
I was on and off.
But it got back to you eventually.
Yes, it did. Well, singing now, I'm always singing. And I love karaoke, by the way. A lot of people say, oh, karaoke. Karaoke is awesome. Mm-hmm. It gives you the, you feel like you're an artist, even though if you think you're not. Mm-hmm. I think everybody, if you are a singer, if you sing with the heart, you are a singer. So don't believe nobody that tells you different, okay?
Yes, I sing two songs.
Yes.
Definitely. And also, you have your manager, I believe?
Yes, that's Fernando Bernier.
Hello. Yes, hi. Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, so like I said, you've been doing it for a long time, singing and also at animation. That's good. Keep doing that.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. So let's talk about more like your influences. Who influenced you in your life as an artist?
It has to do a lot with my family. All my family, my I guess I'm a composer because I take after an uncle. They all wrote their own songs. They will play instruments, and they all sing very beautiful. Even my grandmother. But nobody made it like to the outside. It was like more a family thing for my family reunions. And a few years ago, I decided to take up. I said, let me get out there to see what's going on. So I started writing songs again and putting them together, and that's how my first album came out.
Okay, Jeremy, we're going to talk about that in a minute. I got you.
Yes, we get there.
I can't wait. But let's see, like, any Latin artists is, like,
you know. Oh, definitely. When I was a young girl, Nidia Caro.
Oh, wow.
She won the OT, and with this song that it sounds so, like, you don't understand this, it's something like, I sing just to sing. Because right now I'm not feeling anything, so that inspired me. Like, also you could sing even when you're sad. Mm-hmm. So then Sandro, Rosa, the maravillosa como blanca. I love Sandro. Mm-hmm. And Julio Jaramillo, that's the guy with the song that my grandma teach me. Mm-hmm. All these artists, my mother used to listen to them. El Trio Los Pancho, El Trio, all these trios. So I grew up like that, so they were all, in a way, influences to me.
And I like that because, you know, as an artist, you always want to know the origin. Like, how did that kind of make you motivate yourself as a person, as where you are today, and also to continue that legacy?
Yes.
You know, and I want to thank you because, a true story, and I'm going to cry about this because when I met you a while back, and I remember you told me to do boleros. Mm-hmm. My dad was a big fan of that many years ago.
Oh,
may he rest in peace. So I have a strong connection with you because of the music of that. That's like love songs, folk tale songs, all that. And it's a beautiful thing to continue on that. So thank you for that.
Mm, you're welcome. And I'm going to sing, and when I do it, I'm going to remember your daddy. I'm going to offer it to him. Memory.
I appreciate that.
One thing that I would like to say, well, it's very important that everybody you follow us and personally you, happy birthday by the way, but again, and La Señora Bolero is the first time it's going to be nominated for one award a corporation called Farándula Global Awards, and you guys are invited for a big cocktail in Art Space and December 9th, which is going to be announced the award that is going to be in Colombia, October 2023. So you guys very welcome to enjoy us, and I will give you all the information as soon as I get everything.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much. And La Señora Bolero is one of the favorite singers from Puerto Rico and all Latin Americans. And thank you so much for the support. And this is Fernando Bernier, his promoter.
Promoter. Yeah, listen, do what you gotta do, man. Thank you so much.
I mean, you're here now.
Congratulations, Mama.
Yeah, thank you.
Oh, very excited. It's like you work, and then suddenly somebody notices.
Qué bueno.
And it's like, yes, it's like a relief. It's like a back of the shoulder, like, yes, I did the right thing, you know?
That is true.
You can relate that.
Yeah, oh, listen.
We all do.
I tell you, but you know what? The thing is, as long as you keep pushing, and if somehow, eventually, people, like you said, give me that recognition, that speaks volumes. So keep doing that. I'm giving a blessing upon
you
now.
Thank you.
Come on, everybody. Yeah. That's what you're going to do. Come on, now.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank
you're welcome. So let's get back into right now. Let's get into the album. Okay. So right now it's called Historia Contando. Did I say it correctly?
Historias Contadas.
Okay. See, my French is not that great, so you already know. But I just want to make sure I get it correct. Okay. Oh, definitely. So tell us more about the album and how you became with the process for that.
Okay. Historia Contadas, in English, Story to Tell, is based on true story events. Everything I see, everything I have lived, I go through it, or went through it, I like writing it.
Oh, wow.
So, one of the songs I dedicated to my mother, to my son, to my brother, Nelson Delgado, because he's an awesome kid. My son is, my sunshine. And Payasa is one song that I love. I really love this song. And I'm going to make a video. We're going to come out with a video and everything, because it's about real life. You know when you get married and he leaves and then he meets another person. Cheating got between you too, so she has nothing to do with that. But then she gets jealous of you and she acts like she doesn't know you, and then she comes to you and look at you like,
oh Lord.
And you'll be like, but why? I didn't do nothing.
Exactly.
So I made that song because of that. And the thing is that she doesn't know that this guy wants this back, but I said no.
Oh,
because
man.
After you touch her, you ain't touching me.
I'm not no second. In fact, I'm the main one.
That's right. Yeah, that's and after being a wife, I'm not going to become a lover.
Yeah, like this is like,
that doesn't make sense, right?
You know, I want to get all the benefits. Come on.
Exactly. So I have a lot of hope with this song. It's like, to me, it's a project. Because I love this song.
That's awesome.
And I have another one that is Hola Tristeza. It's a very important song to me. This song, I wrote it bending on my knees, asking to Jehovah to please give me some comfort because I had just lost my mother. So this song is about that, how I was feeling. That means high sadness.
Yeah.
Hello sadness. So that's another song that, oh guys, I wanna record it in English too. That's my next project that I wanna do with that song.
Oh, that's great.
Because I know a lot of people are gonna relate with this song. Mm-hmm. And I know it's gonna be good.
Thank you, Chairman. And like you said, yeah, you're working on that for the next project. The English version of that.
The second album is coming out soon.
What? See, we're getting exclusive here on the show now.
Yes, it's coming out soon. Oh, and it's gonna be Historias Contadas Volume 2 because it's also all my compositions.
Oh wow. So it's a continuation of that?
Yes, it's a continuation of the first one.
I love that. And it's like pretty much the whole album is, like you said, things you went through in the past, things like
things that I see people going through.
See. And things that people could heal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we all need healing in our time.
Exactly.
With different situations, so.
Exactly.
It's easy. Oh, you're going to be crying now. Definitely. So, we're going to play in a bit because I have to wait till he comes back. We got the first song which you sent us. I hope I said it right. Is it Papa? I'll let you say it.
Payasa.
See, my Spanish is horrible, okay?
Woo! That is clown.
Clown. Okay, that's my Spanish horrible. And the second one is El que la hace la paga, right?
Yeah, what you do, you pay for it.
Ooh, see, that sounds kind of hot there. Right? Hey, now. See, how does that? Well, we're going to get that played in a minute, but before that, talk about also, besides the wording of the nomination you accepted, which we are honored to have you. Just blessings, mamita.
No, thank you. My honor to be here, my privilege. You're an awesome girl. You're an awesome person. You're an awesome artist. I'm telling you. It's good to follow you.
Thank you, mommy.
People do follow her because she's awesome.
No, I'm just like, whatever they are. But back to you, mommy. So, let's talk about the Latin community, right? Now, being a Latin artist, what do you think needs to be more of a change that you see as a Latin artist in general?
Latin artists, we need to stick together. Mm. We need to stop competing.
Yes.
If you win something, I'm going to be glad, I'm going to be happy, I'm going to be there, I'm going to be clapping, and from my heart out. If you need a song and you want me to write with you and help you do it, I will do it. Because it's about being together. It's not about competition. It's about supporting each other. To me, I believe in that 100%. And everybody that has worked with me in all these years, they know that this Señora Bolero is not lying.
No, eso se la verdad. I mean, and I seen some things like that prior when I started years ago. Mm-hmm. And it's not even like community, it's just a general. And it's true, like I said, we have to unite more because there's too much things going on. It's not enough being able to people stuff as it is. We need more people like yourself and everyone out there in the room as well. So we stay positive and keep pushing out great content. You know?
Exactly.
Definitely.
Yes. Definitely.
No, not a problem. So any advice out there for anybody that's tuning in right now for what your experience?
Okay. Something that marked my life about 12 years ago, it was this. I was looking this interview with Juan Gabriel. He was an excellent artist, one of the best ones that we have in Latin music.
Yes.
And he rest in peace, yes. And they were asking him, he was trying to help somebody to make it out there, to become a singer. And the guy asked him, yeah, but you help him, but he's not a singer. Oh, he's not a real singer. And he goes, and what is a real singer to you? What are you talking about?
Yeah.
And then he goes, oh, you know, he's not, what, because he's not famous? Let me tell you something. Singer to me, it is the person that sings with the heart.
See?
That gives you the vibe when they sing it and makes you feel. So that's a singer. That day, I said to myself, you see, Naomi, you are a singer. Because that's exactly how I sing. So he had so much to do with me getting up. I said, this is what I want to do. This is what I'm going to do.
I see it.
Thank you, Juan Gabriel. Rest in peace, wherever you are right now.
Oh, see, he's watching out from heaven.
Yes, yes.
That is amazing. That is amazing. Would you like to bless us before we get the music queued up? Would you like to bless us something from one of your songs before? Like a cappella or something?
Oh, a cappella. You want me to do a cappella?
Anything, because I know, you got to hear it, Imad. You got she.
I'm here.
Okay, she's I'm here already.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, I don't know if you know, and Mi Viejo San Juan is a song that is from Puerto Rico, right?
Uh-huh.
So I'm going to give you a little bit of that, because right now, you know, Puerto Rico just went through a lot.
Yeah, the hurricane.
And
yeah.
The hurricane, and just the state, and now it's happening in Florida.
See.
So I want to sing a little bit of this Mi Viejo San Juan just for them to feel that I have them in my heart, and also my family in Florida right now. They all my family is in Florida.
Okay.
So they'll be okay.
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 When you're ready.
En mi viejo San Juan, ¿cuántos años por qué? En mis años de infancia, mi primera ilusión y mis cuitas de amor son recuerdos del alma. Una tarde me fui, así extraña nación, pues lo quiso el destino. Pero mi corazón se quedó frente al mar, en mi viejo San Juan.
Woo! Get a sad name? Listen, I got children covering
she
up.
She's going to see me at room.
No,
I was just about to say she's friendly.
Yeah,
she's
sad. Exactly. I'm going to be like, oh, man. Lord, not right now.
Yeah,
that's for you guys.
Yeah.
No, but you're welcome. Yeah, so that's beautiful. Like, and yeah.
I recorded also.
Yes.
It's coming out.
Oh, see. Okay, so that's for the next album.
Mm.
Oh,
so it's gonna be a single.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna put that out as a single.
Oh, I like this already. Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay. Yeah. So do you have any upcoming shows besides the project you're working on right now?
Yeah, we're working.
Go ahead, come on.
Actually, yeah.
He's the boss.
Yeah, go ahead, come on.
We're working on it. One of the presentation of Bolero of the Night with La Señora Bolero. And we don't know yet the month of that's going to happen because I don't know if I can say it, but I'm going to say it.
Okay.
I'm very proud of her because she's a cancer survivor and she's still fighting. And it's something that I applaud for her, but it never, never stop. And that's what I'm here. It's been a long, long time that we tried to work together, and she met me like 5 years ago. And I say, no, you know, I'm being busy all the time, but when I find out what she's going through, what she's going through, and she never stopped writing and singing. So that's an artist, and that's what I'm so proud of, La Señora Borrego.
Thank you. Thank you for the kind words, Fernando. I'm so happy to work with you. That was nice. That was very nice.
Oh, man. That is a beautiful thing. That's why I wanted to, I don't even want to talk about that because there might be something sensitive, but if you want to tell the viewers or listening about your journey with that, you know.
Yes, I had like a feeling that I had cancer, but finally I found somebody that decided to make the surgery because I was in a lot of risk. So when they did the surgery on December 17th, they did find out that I had cancer when they removed everything, and instead of going home next day, I even went to a rehabilitation center for 3 months.
Oh, wow.
It was very, very, very bad. But I started writing songs in the rehabilitation center because that's who I am. So I kept on singing and whatever I was feeling, it was helping me to write more and more. So I tell everybody, all the women out there, please, please, if you don't need all that things inside that we have and you reach certain age, take it out. Do what you need to do. And when you feel the symptoms, they're going to tell you, it's not normal to bleed after menopause. And they tell you, it's okay, you don't have cancer, the pap smear is okay.
Oh, wow.
No, it's not okay. Look at me. I was on stage one, but it was carcinoma cancer that is it's aggressive. So right now, I'm in the waiting what's gonna happen.
Okay.
But I'm waiting while I wait, I do what I gotta do. See. Because I believe if you have life right now, enjoy it. If you have life right now, be grateful.
Amen.
Do what you gotta do. Hug somebody, tell somebody that you love them. Because why are you gonna be like, I have a dream. At the beginning, I was so devastated. Then I decided, I was like in a swinging mood.
Yeah.
You know, it was like here, I'm happy, then I'm not happy. But then I decided my son is out there suffering, crying, my grandkids, they my life. And my sister Nancy, she was like, she was losing another mother, the way she was acting, my brother. You know, my family was there, like, showing me how they care, how much they care, and friends too. So I said, no, you gotta get up. You gotta get up and do what you gotta do. So that's what I did. That's what I told you. Anything happens like that, go to GYN.
Yes.
But try to make it to the oncologist, GYN. They take you serious because they want to fight cancer. They want a big cancer.
Exactly.
So they're very aware of the word cancer. So once you got symptoms, they're going to go for it. So please, woman, take care of yourself. Endometrial cancer is very painful.
Yeah, you're right about that. Oh, man, that's crazy. But you know what? I think the best thing right now you said is primary prevention.
Prevention.
Prevention, yeah. Because prevention. That's very, very needed. You know, especially in times that we go through all certain things and that.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel the best thing that you said is take self-care.
Self-care.
You have to take care of yourself. If you feel something's wrong, like you said, go against it. You know, and it is what it is, you know. Welcome back on the show. How are you guys doing?
Good. How are you?
Tired. No, you're good. So, guys, welcome back to the show. Since last time we had you, you guys been doing a lot.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to go, how we do this, we're going to go right to Image, and then go to the...
Okay.
So...
Can you slide on?
Yeah. So,
hey, okay,
stay still. The fuck?
They got excited.
Yeah,
like, man. I'm about to do the
thing. Don't fall down, Lisa. Don't fall in there.
You won't break my soul.
Woo! You're Beyonce being okay. Oh, we got ready. me touch it.
It looks amazing.
Oh, damn. Okay, no, you're good. You gotta get the camera out of there. I can't see. All right, so back to you guys. All right, so Maj, since the last time you see me here, you have done amazing.
You are.
Now, let's get right into it. Okay, so you have a new album coming up. It's being pushed back to me.
Again.
Okay, but let's talk more about the album and what it entails for the album.
The album is gonna come from a personal place, but how I describe it is external feelings. So it's gonna be like relatable to everybody, but still come from me. Like, you know, like the things I've been through, I want it to where everybody be like, oh, I've been through that, oh, I've been through that. So it's something for everybody, different subject matters. I'll just say this will be a personal song on the album that's really, when you hear it, you'll be like, you know. Cause he heard it.
So you hear it. You get a
tattoo.
Like, what's up?
You hear it. You're like, shit. What the? How? Tell me what that you want to know. And it's gonna stand out. It's gonna be the most standout song. It's gonna be the standout song on the album. I'll just say that. And it was very difficult to even write that song because that situation really put a dent on me. Because I never thought I'd be accused of something like sinister like that. I'll just give you that much. But yeah, like, but I have to think, like, I'm an artist. I have to be relatable. I'm going to come from a real place. And when I put this out, you know, it'd be, everything would be on point. In terms of the harmonies, I have to think of, like, more harmonies. Or, like, if I left out any, with all the songs, by the way, anything I left out, need to put in. I'm going to make sure everything's mixing mastered properly. So I'm going to be honest. Watching next year is like my best bet. Ooh. Because I care about my baby. It's my first project ever. I care about it. I'm not gonna release any bullshit because I'm an artist who don't give a fuck. So I'm not gonna be in that position. So
take your time. That's what I'm saying. They take your time.
Yeah, so it'll be like damn near 6 years. And it's just like I'm the people who be like, oh, Normani and Chloe, and they doing the same thing. But see, the difference between them and me, I'm underground independent, however you want to call it. I have plenty of time, and not everybody knows me, so I can get away with it. They're actually bigger than me, way bigger than me. They have people have expectations for them.
They have deadlines.
Exactly. Yeah. And apparently they don't at the moment because label issues.
Yeah.
Meaning I'm not under no label, I'm under lyrics.
Yeah.
So it's just like he doesn't pressure me on my end, you know what I'm saying? But if we like doing singles and stuff like that, like with me and you, we quit. But you know, like the same was with like anybody that we plan to work with, then it's just like, okay, we need you to be on your P's and Q's. You know what I'm saying? But like, I won't be like, no. And then I talk about singles, me too. And speaking of singles,
I'll let you do it.
I'm not going to say the name, but I have a single that's going to be coming out in November. Finally, yes, I got the single off the album. Oh my God, it's been so hard because like I've been choosing a single off and on because I want to make sure it stands out and I have to think about timing and how if it's the right timing and stuff like that. I want to say the name somewhere, but I can't. It's like, yeah.
You want to put like a letter, so people get the.
I'll give you the acronym.
Okay.
So it's DOMN. That's it.
I'm not bringing my head to that with that shit.
D-O-M-N.
Okay, got it.
Right, yeah, so like basically, that song is like a I had enough type of shit. But yeah, I'm in my bag. Like,
no, but you know what? Let it out.
You know what I'm saying? Because like certain people pissed me off.
Oh, I think I know what you're talking about now. Okay, I caught it.
That's just me. So when I spoke to him about it, I saw him get into a song a little bit. So basically, when I wrote a verse for whoever pissed me off, it was just like,
yo, like, I couldn't believe myself. I was like, y'all really went in on it. So when he heard it, he was like, yo, leave that shit in here. I was like, hell yeah, because, like, what are you talking about? I'm gonna speak my piece. Because it's like, you know, like, people in general think that, you know, when you do what you do, they laugh at what you're doing. It's like, what the fuck on? Who are you? And you ain't got shit going on. Who the fuck you think you are? You know what I'm saying? You know, y'all know the situation. I was needed. I was fucking needed. So that inspired me to write the verse for that situation. I'm telling you, that single's gonna be like, and you know, it's different from the other singles I released. Yes. I'll say that. And when it comes out, I already got the idea for the video and everything. It's gonna be a situation.
No digits. That's all I'm gonna say.
Yeah, so get ready for November. That's all I'm gonna say. Get ready for November.
I'm ready, let's get it.
Yeah. But yeah, back to the album a little bit. But yeah, so it's gonna come from, like I said, personal experiences. Hopefully people would like enjoy it and stuff like that. And the beats that I've chosen, melodies, everything is gonna be, yeah. So when it comes out, y'all, I'm fucking hyped.
No, but it's good because now your fans and supporters are now anticipating for it. So.
Yes, that's why I want to apologize to the fans and whoever's watching, trying to get to know me. Like, you know, this is a hard process.
It is.
You can't just pick up a woman and go, I'm gonna release an album tomorrow. It doesn't work that way. People could work on an album for 2 weeks and go, ta-da, Beyonce did it for B-Day. I'm not that type of bitch. Like, I'm sorry. Like, I can't run my work. I want to make sure the things I say matter. That's effective and it hits people. Like, I like that lyric. I like that rhyme. Like, it's something, like, make you feel me. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
She got me anticipating. Okay.
But thank you, Gemini. You just said happy birthday.
Hey, what's up, Gemini? Really, he was supposed to come today, but he came late, so we had to hurry up down here. So. But I'll see you later on. yeah, that's what's up. So you said it's gonna be by next year.
Okay. Yeah, next year. That's all I can give you. When I definitely get a release date.
Okay.
I'll let everybody know.
Okay. And it's untitled for now.
No, the title's still called Life.
Okay.
That's still staying there because I want people to get like an idea of like, you know, how life is in general.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And I wanted to make the track so relatable as possible, but still come from a personal state.
Yes. Yes. And I guess we'll announce it here on the show first because I didn't really kind of mention it. I did, but I
don't. I'm sorry if I spoke
it. Oh, girl, I'm so sorry. It's all right. Listen, it's all good. All right, we'll both announce it in the sense, right? So
yeah.
Me and Amaj are doing a collaboration and I'm just doing that.
Okay, so you want? I'm not gonna say this on time.
No.
All right. But I'll just say that I have to thank you. I have to thank you, Queen, because you did a lot for me. You really put me on the map along with Pops. Y'all really helped me out. Like, I can't even, it's like, I'm so fucking proud of both of you. Aww. And I can't believe, like, I impacted y'all to come together. Like, be me here and that makes me happy. Because we all want unity, you know what I'm saying? We all want to, like, do music together. We always wanted to, you know what I'm saying? And when I heard Open Bars, I was like, yo, part two. I'm right there. I'm in the middle.
And we did.
I'm in the middle. And it manifested it, and it hit 1K in 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And it radio play was sick, man. I was like, oh my fucking God, it was meant to happen.
That is good.
But, like, our collaboration, I'm so fucking honored that you want to do a song with me, Queen. I'm telling you, that's going to be a hit.
Yeah.
That's not gonna be a hit. I don't care what the fuck is telling me. I don't care. We're gonna, yo.
Shit.
I wanna say more, but I'm not gonna say a lot. But like, once
again, stay tuned.
Thank you so much. And I'll just say it's an uplifting song.
Yes.
We gotta uplift like each other at the hard times. You know what I'm saying? It's just a lot going on. The hurricane, people dying, COVID still here. Somebody left. No, it didn't.
Shit.
All this unnecessary shit going on. Sometimes you need a little lightness. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And I'm glad, man, you get to do that. When people hear this shit, they're like,
what the fuck out of here? Yo.
That's all I want to say. I want to.
He's like,
produced it. I'll just say that. Came over here. Okay. Real Lyrics produced it. That's it. That's all I'm giving y'all. Don't ask for no more.
We're in there. Definitely. But more things to come.
Yeah.
So any other projects you're working on? And our shows or showcases or anything that you're doing.
Showcases on my show yet. Eventually, when that happens,
yes.
You'll let me know.
Yeah.
There's more collaboration.
Woo!
I say that. I got a chance to meet Champagne. Shout out to her. She couldn't be with us.
Okay.
But when I met her, she's a sweetheart. Yes. And I heard some things from other artists that wasn't pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
And it bothered us because it was just like, hold on, like, she's not what you're saying she is. That's what we were thinking. And then it's like, we figured who she was not only, she's good people, like, so
yeah.
We just decided, you know what, we gonna do us, you know, me, him, or whoever, we're gonna work with us,
right.
So it was just like, yeah, she's really a cool person, like, I like her, she's sweetheart, shout out to Shannon, yeah, there's all the collaborations, I just need that better,
Put the big word, stay tuned, you're ready to Let's talk about your song Blaze, okay, because when I saw the song, the video, yo, I'm not gonna lie, we're all adults here, right? Okay, so it got me kind of like intense. Let's just put the
right word you wanted to be in.
Well, I'm gonna go to basketball for a minute.
Oh.
You know what I'm talking about?
You wanted to be in basketball?
Yes!
She wanted to be in basketball.
Okay, now to watch that video, please do, because it's very intense. And it's just beautiful. It brings a sensuality of you as a beautiful R&B artist. And it brings out, it's just the songstress, and I feel it. When you sang that in the video, the complementary of both of them is in one. So it's just amazing to see that. And you don't see that much at all in videos. Especially now, the R&B and stuff like that is very, it's a rarity, you know? So, yeah, I just want to applaud you for that. So I was like, okay, girl, can I be the best?
I'm gonna be honest, like, looking back at that video, I didn't think it would be as iconic as it was. I didn't think it was a cast hardcore. That shocked the fuck out of me. Like, one day, like, I was promoting it, and then, like, when I woke up, I forgot which day it was, and that shit went to 6K on Spotify. I was like, wait, what? I was like, it's a cast hardcore on Spotify. I was like, yo, they really love the fuck out of this song. And I was very insecure about my singing. That was another thing too. That Blaze was intentionally not supposed to be the single.
Wow.
I was very, after hardcore, I was like, talking to him all the time. What should I do? What kind of song should I release?
Yeah.
I want to be something that's going to hit them. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to show my versatility. How do I do it? It was a lot. It's a strategy. I have to, like, really, you know, think about and stuff like that. I was looking over all my songs that I wanted for the album. It was just a lot of pressure. So when I found the beat from NK Music, he's the producer. When I heard the beat, it had a sexy feel to it. And it made me, like, do all these, like, in my room.
Like, this is getting hot in here now.
Yes.
Where's the fan right now?
And then I thought to myself, like, I can't write no basic ass love song.
Yeah.
I didn't want to do that.
So
I thought to myself, like, who should be the inspiration? And then, like, the person I thought of, I was like, let me describe him. And I described the fuck out of him, and he heard it.
He caught it.
And as we talked about it, I told him the truth. He knew. Z1 picked it up, and it was just like, I just want to make sure he don't get to it. But you know, I was just like, when you hear the words, you know I'm talking about somebody. Because I'm describing
the details,
like the details of a man and how he make me feel as someone question, you know, as someone that's questioning on him.
You basically be like telling him, like, yo, I want you. Like,
yes.
Sense, you know,
I didn't care about the girlfriend. I didn't care about none of that.
Shit.
I was just like, I have a little thing for you.
Stop it, girl.
You me if I told you that I didn't care. I didn't care.
Yeah,
and then the video. Oh my god, the video. Wait. Like, when we did the video, I was like, oh my god, am I here? Like, are we really doing this? And then, like, Z1, let me tell you, when I found out Z1 loved the song, because he told me Z1 loved the song, and Z1 has his own way of showing you he really likes something.
Yeah.
This man said, go here, do it like this, do it like that. He was a scene while I was on the bed. Boom.
Like, I was like,
filming me, I was like, for it.
No, eat them grapes. Eat them grapes.
They were killing me with the jump on the bed, do this and do that. But when you look at it, it was fucking worth it. It's sexy, it's sensual, feminine. You see a woman, you see maturity a little bit in there. You know what I'm saying? You can see, you know, you see me.
Confidence. That's what I see.
Yes, ma'am.
Especially being a woman of our stature.
Yeah.
It, you know, Lizzo, I give it up for her. She's a little too much sometimes, but she's breaking the way for us. See what I'm saying?
Speaking of that, okay, yes. I have to realize, like, while I was doing this video too, not to be over-sexualizing. Okay. And, like, so I have to, like, move, like, you know, sensual, feminine, yeah. Not too much to be able to stick my ass out.
No, no, not
to or film my, I didn't want to do all that. Yeah. I wanted to showcase my face more. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm into, like he was, like, if he was in front of me, how I act. That's basically what I was giving. And the pillow scene, you know the pillow? I was holding like, I was holding the pillow like it was him. Mm-hmm. So even though some people didn't get that, of course you wouldn't, because when I was doing too much to the pillow, that's what I was doing to him.
Got it.
That's what I was trying to portray.
You don't pick up things.
He was no. He just wanted to be like, oh, you, this video, because I saw comments like that. I don't give a fuck. It's not for you to understand. It's my video.
Exactly. If they like it, fine and not, keep moving. That's it. That's what you can do.
Your work.
Yes. And then, of course, it hit 10K on yes. YouTube. Yes. There it is. Yo. I was like, that's so heavy as fuck. I was like, when I saw 10K, I was like, what? And I knew it was coming. And then LDM Radio.
Yes.
Oh my God. It hit top 10 for 7 consecutive weeks.
Yes.
That's great. Yes. And then it fell off. It happens. Yes. But I feel like this time around, I'm going to hit either number 2 or number 1 because when it happens,
it will happen.
Oh my God.
That's what I'm going to say.
Yo.
Listen, if people fuck with it, they're going to fuck with it. I'm telling you. And that's why I said with the video and the visuals and the audio, mm-hmm. It was crazy because you don't see that. I'm telling you.
No, you don't.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, keep doing that. Like,
I want to bring out more of my womanly side. I don't always want to be hood all the time.
Well, because
sometimes when they first see you do something, they want you to consistently be doing
it.
Kind
of support
you. No, yeah. You're not going to get that from me.
Yeah, that's
and then I did features with him. I did Us Together,
yes.
Other people. You saw different. Mm-hmm. Flows, different beats I've been in, all that. You'd be like, oh my God, this bitch is versatile. She really sticks to her guns. Yes, I do. Mm-hmm. I would do a rock song. I would do.
See, that's what I was like. Actually, what like other genres would you like to tap into? Like,
oh.
We're getting right into it. Looking at you, real like. I'll stay out of it.
Okay, okay. I have to look because you know what
we're saying.
I don't want to be like. You know what I mean? Yeah, because there's some niggas that like to spill out shit.
Okay, so I'm feeling that. Okay.
Okay, so basically, we're working on a Celtic rock song.
What? Girl, rock that shit.
Yeah, we talked about this for a year. But we wanted to find the right timing. We wanted to make sure it, like, all the lyrics and everything was, like, for that time.
Yeah.
So when I found the the instrumental, which is produced by Ronnie Beats.
Ooh.
I shouldn't be giving that away, but fuck it. Yeah, I'm not gonna know because I'm not gonna fucking tell you where it is. I'm not doing none of that. But that's it. That's all you get from me. All I know is that he's producing it. Excuse me, he produced it. Oh my God, I'm stuttering. I hate that. I wrote my verse. Well, most of it. You loved it. And then I'm pretty sure he's still working on it. When it's time to record everything, then we'll put our energy into it. But it's different. He always wanted to work with an artist that's like out. The fucking box, like.
Stand out.
You know what I'm saying? We're aliens in this fucking industry. You know what I'm saying?
Like, come on, man.
Yeah, we like to be out the box. We don't want to be like, oh, you're black, you should do that. You're Hispanic, you should do that.
Yeah.
You're white, you should do that. How about fuck all the stereotypes and let me do what I want?
It's because you want to, like, kind of stand out. That's the point.
Right. Yes.
It's not So tell people to vote for you, by the way, for www.LDMRadio.com for
Blaze. For the song Blaze, please vote for me on LDMRadio.com. Vote for me on the R&B section. Please give me so much to me because I want to get either number two or number one, maybe number one. So, you know, be nice, you know, show your love and your respect, you feel me? That's my most successful song. I am very blessed to even write the song the way I did. It was just, everything's just the timing. I'm just happy.
Yeah.
And then, yeah,
you got this, girl, you got it. She's like, yeah, babe.
Yeah.
You good, you good. We're going to play your song a bit. We'll see if it works here because he's in charge of music. And now I will play with my phone. Fuck, we'll make the best of the situation. So stay put.
Right.
But before we continue, tell them your social media.
If you want to follow me.
Oh, stay
behind
here.
Follow me. Yeah, he like that song back.
Oh,
you're best. All right. You want to follow me? My Instagram is Imaj Music, E-I-M-A-J Music. I have another one with the same name with the number two next to it. My YouTube is simply Imaj, E-I-M-A-J. And my Facebook, Imaj Morales, M-O-R-A-L-E-S. If you can remember all that, I'm sorry.
Figure that shit out.
That's your business. That's your business.
Hi, Richard. Any shout outs you have for anybody watching right now?
Shout out to my best friend Nicole. Wait, no, I can't see that.
Uh oh.
Shout out to my best friend Opal. Opal, you met her.
Yeah,
you met her.
Okay. Yeah.
That's my baby. I love her. Oh, shout out to my mommy. Hi, mom.
Aww.
You're gonna watch this soon. My mommy, shout out to the haters.
Yeah,
one of them is gonna fucking watch it.
Influence.
Why would you do that? Y'all said it, not me. You saw them shits though?
Gordon.
They're supposed to look like this. The shit look like this. I was like, get the fuck out
of
here.
I'm dying.
Like, we got to push it up.
Yeah,
this video, you did right. Yeah, shit's good from wish.com.
Stop. Oh my god.
Without leaving my neighborhood, I saw one of your stores.
Yeah, you showed it to me. That's a good Air Floridians, man.
The Air Floridians.
Air Floridians.
Floridians. I believe I can fly.
We did not fly down. We don't want to smoke cactus in the fucking air. It's way better than it's polluting. Why would you want to be with my dad?
Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm dying.
I hope he get mad when he sees this. Because he always mad about something.
Okay, let's change the mood a little bit. It's a birthday celebration, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Happy birthday, Quinny!
Yeah, you're
right.
And you too, guys. Happy birthday. Happy belated birthday, guys. I can't sing right now. My voice is still a back cold, so I might, you know what? Fuck it. Let me go with it. You ready, guys?
Yeah.
If I sound like shit, just go along with it. All right, just for all the birthday Virgos and Libras and for you guys in the building. Right, here we go. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Imaginary Lyrics. Happy birthday. Damn it, sorry. Sorry. You caught me in the moment.
Right
now. Shit. All right, so Rhythm, what's up, brother? How you doing, man?
I'm doing doing good, man.
It's been a minute since we last saw you.
Yo. Superstar, best believe it.
Woo, shit. Damn. Yeah. So, what's up?
Just still working on it. The album is done. Right now, I just pushed it back.
The Architect?
Yeah.
Okay.
We got to be this long. You need to know it.
Yeah.
No, just a few songs that you can write. Like, we do over there. Some of the lyrics that we do over there. Yeah. Okay. I already put out two singles, one that album. That's from Open Bar.
Yes.
That's
Beyond Blue, right? Yeah, Beyond Blue. Okay. Beyond Blue and Okay, so those two are out now. What made you make the new concept song, the album, the concept? Now you got me fucking for shit. I try to keep everything related to me. So that's being also, like you mentioned, for next year.
Yeah.
Oh, because you said you have to work some more. You know, songs
and
shit.
Yeah, more.
Okay.
Okay, what
It's like Mickey Mouse. Come on.
Watch it.
Ew, don't do that.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Put me in the house now.
Yeah, just put it in.
Fuck it. Let's light that shit up, baby.
It should be 20 minutes.
There you go.
You're out of wish. Go back 10 years.
Alright, ready?
Alright, ready,
yes,
go
ahead. Guys. Ready, guys?
Okay. In Spanish, one time.
Okay.
Feliz, feliz en tu día, amiguita, que Dios te bendiga, que reine la paz en tu día, y que cumplas muchas más.
It's good.
Happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Hey, guys.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.